Hello, welcome to episode 38 of the Harry Potter painting series. In this one, as you can see, we're doing a unicorn. Apologies if you haven't got an airbrush, because it's about 90% airbrush on this one. But hopefully it'll make you decide that you want to get an airbrush and you give it a go. Anyway, I hope you enjoy it, and let's get straight into it. Okay, so I've prepped, primed, ready to go on the unicorn. I use grey primer from Halfords, but only because I haven't got any black, because I've got my black and my airbrush now. I'm just going to spray the underside. I don't want a really intense black. Just a little bit of shadow. So I'm going underneath and I'm going in the creases on the hind legs and the forelegs, and in the chest there. Not an awful lot. Yeah, so it's not too much. Before we move on to the next colour now. Will be grey. Okay, moving on to the grey then. I'm going to go for about an angle of 45 degrees. I'm doing is starting off in the middle of the back and working my way down towards the belly. Blocking quite a bit today, which is great. I'm going on the flanks, so I'm trying to stay away from the area that I've already shaded with the black. See, I'm starting to get a nice transition there already, just with a grey. I might go closer to the crease now. I'm a bit too close for my liking, but we'll stick with it. Got a little patch in there. You've done the cheek there. Try and do the neck as well now. And the front of the chest. Again, trying to stay away from the shadow. Thank you. remember, if you lower your air pressure, you can go a bit closer and then get a narrower spray area. So that's what I'm doing. With this, I can kind of control where I'm adding the highlights. Building up the intensity now on the raised areas. Before we switch colours. So happy with that. Okay, what I'm going to do now, instead of going to white, I'm going to use ivory just to give it a different tone, really. But I'm not going to go as far down the belly as I did with the light grey, just staying up towards the back, which I think is normally the lightest area. See what we come up with. Just building it up slowly. It's a bit on the legs here. I'm trying to create volume, so I'm going to highlight that area there and there, and then come down to about there, maybe, or try that bit, and then there. If I can get enough control, there's like raised areas, raised muscles. Try and pick out each of these, and then the cheek of the horse, but it's mostly going to be on the flanks. On the top there, and I'll try highlighting that bit there as well. It's going to be difficult, but we'll give it a go. So I'm just going to drop the pressure down a little bit more, so hopefully I'll get more control. I don't want to go too low. I'm going to turn it up. I'll try an error. Okay, I'm going on the other side now. I just going over bits I think I've missed. Okay, I'm not sure if it's going to show up under the harsh lighting, but it's given quite a nice tone now, so I think I'll leave that dry and we'll probably have another pass with the airbrush on that colour as well. So yeah, happy so far. Okay, so I'm going to give it another coat of the ivory now. I haven't got that much paint to play with at the minute. Ah, look. No worries. Just soak it up. Bit of a blend in while I'm there. Not too bad. See, I've got my pressure wrong now. Alright, I'll pause it there and we'll come back, I think. Although that's not looking too bad. I'll just check my pressure. It's quite high actually. I'll stick with it. A bit under the mane now, try and get rid of that patch. Try and blend round the mistakes we made earlier. That's the ivory done. I'm going to go with off-white next. Okay, moving on to white next. And this is going to be the absolute overhead highlight now. Venturing into a little bit of that area now. I'm not going very far down the flank either. Probably see how thin the paint is now. Hang on. Low battery. Let's close that. Okay. So that's very, very little coming out here. Though. You can see I'm very close to the miniature as well. Oh, that wasn't very good, was it? Another splat. So, it's going to get rid of that altogether. I'm not going to dab it because it's an awkward area to get into. I know the previous layer was dry, so let's get a towel to soak up the excess. And we'll start again. Let's do the tops of the legs as well. Try this cheek again. That's better. All right, I'm going to stop there before I mess it up even further. And we'll do the details now. Okay, slight detour onto the base. I've been struggling with deciding what to do with the base. I've recently done some pumpkin patches and they looked okay, so I was thinking maybe doing a forbidden forest board. So I think I'm gonna take some of the tips from the pumpkin patch and use this for the base on this one. So I'm gonna have to pin it, so I've got my paperclip ready and my pin vise. And I'll make a pin, so I'm cutting the paperclip and keeping that to one side. And I'll tidy up the underside. Swing a scalpel. So it's relatively flat. Happy with that. And because I use PVA and pigment mixed into it, I'm going to cover up the underside of the base using masking tape. That's ready, and I'll gauge where the rocky bit is going to go. So it's going to be fairly central-ish. So I'll just make a hole there. So just drill it through. Make it a little bit wider. And the next thing is to do a corresponding hole on the bottom of the unicorn. Just check how far I've gone in. So that's about 5 mil. I think I might be in danger of going outside of the hoof there, so I'm going to stop there. Test fit the pin. And we'll glue it in. Trusty super glue. So I'm going to support the ankle or the hoof of the unicorn. I'm going to push the pin in using my clippers to make sure it's gone all the way in. And I'll leave that to dry before I'll trim it off. I'm not going to attach it to the base yet. But what I'm going to do is have a test fit. I think I need to go a bit wider on the hole there. I've got a test fit and I'm going to mark side of where this little rock is so that I don't apply any of the PVA to it. So it's about there or thereabouts. I'll put him off to one side for a minute. So I've got a little bit of filler to put in the gap, and I'll leave that dry because if I just put PVA on the top of this now, it'll just sink in and it'll soak the masking tape underneath. So I'll just smooth this out with a, I can't find a flat tool, so I'll just use a brush. Let's get rid of the excess. Well, it's just a matter of waiting for that to dry before we put the PVA on. So the filler's dried. I'm ready to add the PVA mix now. So I've got PVA in a little pot and I'm just going to add some dark mud pigment to it. I've added a little, you know, it's a couple of drops of water to this as well, but doesn't really need it. Mix away. So once you're preparing this, it might be a good idea to get a little, couple of little rocks if you wanted to put rocks in there. Because I see the unicorn's actually, one of the hoofs is resting on a rock, so I might put another couple in there. Okay, so I'm ready to transfer onto the base. Again, there's no great technique to it, just pour it on and smooth it out. Got more than enough there. So again, I'm missing a flat tool again. I don't know what I've done with it. Let's have a look here. Well, I've got the back end of a pair of tweezers, that'll do. That's fairly flat. I'm just going to spread it out. Get it up to the rim on the edge. And I can feel where the hole is underneath now, and I'm not gonna do it now. I'll wait till it dries a little bit, and then I'll just make a little indent there. It'll be easier to move when it's more viscous. You know, it's getting near to dry. So we'll leave that for a bit. Just making some uneven little peaks and troughs there. And I'll leave that to dry. Forgot the stones. So I know the hole is going to be there. So I'll just add a few bits just to make it interesting. I got these from a variety of places. I'm a bit sad really. When I go to a beach or something, I always look for little stones around the edge of the cliffs there, and or in the road. Find these little stones at the end of the road. And they do come in handy. I think that's enough actually. No, I'll put another one in. It's a flat bit of slate there. Like. I'm conscious of where his other hoof is going to be. Oh, we'll go there. Right, I'll definitely leave it to dry now. Okay, so the base has been drying for about an hour or so now. And I'm just going to locate the hole by putting my pin vise through. I'll do. Take the unicorn and attach it to the base. And hopefully I can locate the hole. Which I can't. Yeah, I got it. All right, there we are. And because we've got the PVA on the base, it'll act as a glue. That should sit on there nicely now. So I'm just going to leave it like that until it's entirely dry, and then we'll finish off the paint job.